A very good morning to all of you guys. Myself Neha Gupta, your mentor for current affairs. So let's quickly begin this video that is for your preparation of current affairs for RBI, SEBI and NABARD phase 1 examination. But before moving on to the first question, guys, if you haven't subscribed our channel, then do subscribe it right now because we upload a lot of important videos that can be of use for you if you are an RBI, SEBI or NABARD aspirant, okay? Next thing is that you can also subscribe to our Telegram group because there you will get the PDF of our sessions, including this session. So that was the information part. Now let's move on to the very first question of the day. So recently, National Commission for Women has launched a country-wide training and capacity building program for women in dairy farming. As part of the program, an event on value-added dairy products was organized at one of the following locations. Identify the venue of the event. So guys, as you can see, the names of different universities are mentioned in the options, out of which option D, Lala Lajpat Rai University of Veterinary and Animal Sciences, is the right answer. So it is located in Hisar in Haryana. So here this event took place. Now what is this program all about? So as the name of this program itself is indicating, that this program is for the training and capacity building of women who are engaged in the dairy farm. So here two purposes are being solved with this one initiative only. First purpose is women empowerment and second purpose is enhancement of quality and value addition in the dairy sector. So these are the two targets that are being hit with this one stone only. So let's have a look in this project, at this project in detail. So guys, the very first thing about this project that you need to know is that women self-help groups, women run milk cooperatives, women entrepreneurs, all of these will be selected by the National Commission for Women itself for the purpose of training. And the training will be given in areas like value addition, quality enhancement, packaging and marketing of dairy products, among others. So all of these are the different aspects of trainings which will be given to the women entrepreneurs who are engaged in the dairy farming sector. Next is, trainers will also be selected by the National Commission for Women only. The first event, as we have already discussed, the title was Value Added Dairy Products. It took place at this university in Hisar, Haryana. Now, the thing that we did not discuss initially was that this event was organized in partnership with Haryana State Rural Livelihood Mission. So do remember this as well. Now, this point is saying that initially this program will be launched at the district level, and by launching it at the district level, by implementing this program at the district level, NCW is aiming to create a sustainable model, a model that can be repeated or replicated at the national level as well. Okay, so I hope that you are understanding the training modules or the training model in the dairy farming sector at the district level, which can be implemented at the national level as well. So this will be created under this initiative. Now we have discussed about this initiative thoroughly. Let's have a look at the National Commission for Women itself. So this was established under the National Commission for Women Act 1990 and the chairperson is Rekha Sharma. Guys, do remember the name of the chairperson because this can be asked in your exams. Next question is, which state has launched Sampan portal to celebrate the 105th birth anniversary of Pandit Deen Dayal Upadhyay? Haryana, Gujarat, Chhattisgarh, Jharkhand, West Bengal are the five options, out of which option A, Haryana, is the right answer. So basically, this Sampan portal, what does this portal do? The citizens of Haryana can register themselves for offering their voluntary service in certain fields, certain social fields like education, skill development, health, etc. So if as a citizen of Haryana you want to offer your services for any kind of service, then you can just register yourself at this Sampan portal, and this portal will help you in directing your efforts towards the targeted groups. Now also do pay attention to this thing, that these sectors like we have education, skill development, sports and agriculture. So these are the sectors and farmer welfare, child development is also there. So these are the sectors in which voluntary services from the citizens are accepted on this Sampann portal under the state government scheme. So already there are certain schemes that cater to these sectors, that cater to the empowerment of these sectors. So the citizens can offer their services under the government schemes to the targeted groups by registering themselves on this Sampann portal. So I hope that you have understood the entire news well. Also, you need to know this thing that this portal was launched on the 105th birth anniversary of Pandit Deen Dayal Upadhyay. So Pandit Deen Dayal Upadhyay was the co-founder of Bharatiya Janata Party. So that was an additional information that you need to know. Now the birth anniversary of this person is celebrated as Antodyay Divas, on which a very important scheme is also there. So Deen Dayal Antodyay Yojana, National Rural Livelihood Mission and National Urban Livelihood Mission. So both of these have the Antodyay word. So do remember this thing. So September 25 is the date on which Antodyay Divas is celebrated, which is also the birth anniversary of Deen Dayal Upadhyay. And on the death anniversary of Deen Dayal Upadhyay, Samarpan Divas is celebrated. And the death anniversary is February 11. So dates of both these days are important for you to remember. So do remember the dates. Moving on to the third question, which of the following products is a GI tag product from Rajasthan? Blue pottery and Pokhran pottery, Molela claywork, Sanganeri hand block printing, Sojat Mehndi, all of the above. So guys, the right answer here is all of the above. All of these are the GI tagged products from Rajasthan. Right now, this question here is here because the Sojat Mehndi has got the GI tag, and all of these products got their GI tags long ago. But the Sojat Mehndi has got the GI tag right now. That's why this question is in news, or this entire news is there. So do remember that Sojat Mehndi from Rajasthan has got the GI tag. Judima, which is a homemade rice wine of a tribe in Assam. So Dimasa is the name of the tribe. Do remember Judima and Dimasa tribe. Judima is the name of the rice wine and Dimasa is the tribe in Assam that brews this wine. Okay, and this has got the GI tag. Now with this, Judima has become the first wine from the northeastern region to get a GI tag. So this makes it all the more important for you to remember. This can become a question in your RBI, SEBI and NABARD phase 2 ARD examination as well. Okay. Next is cucumber from Nagaland has also got a GI tag, and these cucumbers are grown organically as part of the Jhum cultivation and these are rich in potassium. So these are the three products that we were talking about. Sojat Mehndi from Rajasthan, Judima wine from Assam, cucumber from Nagaland. These three products have recently got their GI tags, which has become the first oil marketing company in India to enable payments via FASTag for fuel purchases by retail as well as commercial customers at its outlets across India. So basically, which company has become the first oil company to enable its users to use FASTag for purchasing fuel? The right answer is HPCL, Hindustan Petroleum Corporation Limited. It has partnered with ICICI Bank to enable the customers of the ICICI Bank who are using the FASTags provided by the ICICI Bank to make the fuel purchase by using the FASTag instead of using the cash or any mode of online payment. Okay, so here the users of the ICICI Bank FASTag will get one tag, will get only FASTag to pay for their fuel purchase, to pay for the parking facility as well as to pay for the toll tax. Okay, so this will basically enhance the ease of traveling for the citizens. So that is the whole idea behind launching this initiative. The next point here is that HPCL launched a first of its kind electric vehicle charger way back in the month of March. The charger is named as ChargeGrid Flair, and it was launched in partnership with Magenta EV Systems, which is a startup. And this Magenta EV startup system was supported under the startup development program of the HPCL. Okay. Also, ICICI Bank and HPCL offer the Coral credit card to the customers so that they can purchase fuel at discounts. So nowadays, a lot of oil companies are partnering with banks so that they can launch their own credit cards for fuel purchases. And on those credit cards, you can get discounts and rewards for purchasing the fuels at the designated outlets of that company which is partnering with the bank. So here, if you purchase the fuel from HPCL by using this card, you will get certain kinds of discounts or rewards. So that is the basic purpose behind launching such kinds of credit cards with banks. Which state has set up the largest startup zone in the entire Southeast Asia? Kerala, Telangana, Karnataka, Andhra Pradesh, and Maharashtra are in the options. The right answer is Kerala. Now guys, before moving into the details of this news, let me first give you a brief introduction. So what has happened is that the Kerala CM has inaugurated Digital Hub at Technology Innovation Zone, which is located in Kochi, Kerala. Now, this Digital Hub is spread across an area of 2 lakh square feet. You will understand this thing that why I am telling you the exact area over which this Digital Hub is spread. Okay, so this Digital Hub is spread across this much area. Now, there is already integrated startup complex, which is also located at the same location, Technology Innovation Zone in Kerala. Now, this is also 2 lakh square feet. Now, this, both of these complexes, both of these entities are located at the same place. Okay, that is Technology Innovation Zone. 2 lakh plus 2 lakh square feet makes it 4 lakh square feet, and thus it becomes the Technology Innovation Zone, becomes the largest space for startups in the entire Southeast Asia. So here the largest refers to the area over which this Technology Innovation Zone is spread, 4 lakh square feet. Okay, so that is the logic behind saying this, the largest startup zone in the Southeast Asia. So I hope that you have understood it well. Now let's understand the basic purpose behind launching the Digital Hub. So this Digital Hub has been launched to support the startups. So in this Digital Hub, there would be incubators, there would be accelerators, there would be center of excellences in emerging technologies, so that all of these can help the startups located in this hub in growing. Okay, so that is the idea behind launching the Digital Hub. Now, this hub has a space for 200 startups. So a total of 200 startups can find a place in this hub. Okay, and this integrated startup complex, it was launched in 2019. It has not been launched right now. It was launched in 2019, and so far it has remained as the largest startup complex in India, largest startup space in India. And now with the addition of this Digital Hub, this Technology Innovation Zone itself has become the largest startup space in the entire Southeast Asia. I hope that this much is clear. Now, what we have discussed so far, this we have already discussed. The thing that we did not discuss is that it was launched under the Kerala Startup Mission. And this is already there, and this is also there. Also remember, this integrated startup complex is India's largest incubation facility. Okay, so under this complex incubation facilities provided to the startups. Now, the state government has a target of 15,000 startups, of having 15,000 startups in the next 5 years. And because of this aim, the Kerala Bank, the Kerala State Industrial Development Corporation, Kerala Finance Corporation, and Kerala Startup Financial Enterprise, all of these organizations are planning to set up a venture capital fund of rupees 250 crores to provide funding to the startups. So this is another initiative that has been proposed by all these entities in order to promote startups in the state. Moving on to the next question. With which company has Ministry of Electronics and Information Technologies Startup Hub signed an agreement to promote technology innovation and sustainable growth of startups in India? So here the right answer is Amazon Internet Services. Now do remember, it is the same organization that provides Amazon Web Services in India, the cloud service of the Amazon. What kind of assistance will be provided to the startups under this partnership that has taken place between this MEITY Startup Hub and this Amazon company? So the assistance will be there in terms of access to AWS credit, a community of access, technical training, support covering cloud architecture, cost optimization, security, and scalability readiness. So all of these are the verticals on which support will be provided by the Amazon to the startups. Okay? And for this only, the MEITY Startup Hub has partnered with this organization. Now this agreement has been signed under the AWS Startup Ramp Program. Do remember the name of the program under which this agreement has been signed. Now, what role will this MEITY Startup Hub play? So it will organize innovation challenges for the startups. So that will be the role of this hub. Moving on to the next question, who has been appointed as a global brand ambassador of MasterCard? So here the right answer is Magnus Carlsen, who is a Norwegian chess player. Whenever you cover the important sports personalities, and he is a magnanimous personality in the field of chess, so your responsibility is to cover his nationality as well. So he is from Norway. Now he has been appointed as a global brand ambassador of MasterCard. And remember that MasterCard has also partnered with, or we can say, the Meltwater Champions Chess Tour has appointed MasterCard as its official partner. Okay, so do remember this as well. And he is Magnus Carlsen. So guys, that was all for today. I hope that you have understood the questions that I have taken up in this video well. Thank you so much for watching the video.